That's what sank Titanic.
We are in the land of the Vikings.
Never seen anything like this. This is the only world like this, and we're still on Earth.
We're trying to find some river systems that haven't been explored, or if they have, very few people have been up them.
All this water, I would bet money that there's got to be some fish.
We want to try to catch the biggest char in these waters.
We call them fire-bellies. That is the fish that dreams are made of.
They can be very challenging to find, but that's what we want to do. We want to go on the hunt and find them.
Believe it or not, this guy, he does not do very good in boats on the ocean. Yeah, once a boat starts doing this from side to side, Jay might be down there.
It's a serious situation. Everybody laughs about it. Everybody thinks they're pretty funny. Pretty funny. But old Puke Master Jay, not very excited about this situation.
Man, I think we're going to have to go up this a ways.
We're hiking 10 miles or so up to the headwaters of Greenland's Elusive River, searching for these monster char. But so far, the fish have been pretty scarce up here. We got the two pessimists and the two optimists.
So what you guys are saying is
positive fish vibes, dude.
You think there is fish up there?
I do, dude. I think there's going to be huge Arctic char, the biggest char we've ever seen. A couple of the guys in the crew aren't very optimistic that we're going to find fish up there. But I had a vision last night. Odin came down from Valhalla, and he told me that there would be fish the size of my leg. Brian and I are convinced we're going to start seeing fish soon, so we're going to walk the river edge to make sure that we don't pass up any of these big fish. Chris and Jay, apparently, they just think that this is a big waste of time.
Brian and Thad are very, very, very confused individuals. And I'll tell you why. Because we've gone another mile up the river. We haven't seen anything. Clearly, this river makes an S-curve back towards that snowy peak. I say we take the high ground up to the headwaters. We'll cut them off. They have to go all the way over there and then all the way back.
Let's do it.
There's a big one down there.
Oh, come on.
I'm not even getting into his world down there. Then we got to get out of here before it gets dark and starts snowing on us.
Long ways away, though.
We at least need to move, because I'm freezing right now. Jay and I are 10 kilometers up this valley. The truth is, I think we hiked a lot farther than we should have today. But there's nothing we can do. We got to hike out.
There are big fish here.
So that's the good thing. But right now, there's bigger issues, and weather is one of them.
The rain. It just keeps coming down. It's just nonstop.
Brian, hey!
Everything in my tent is wet. I can't get warm.
How's JJ?
I don't know, I haven't checked on him yet.
JJ, you alive, man? Oh my God. Are you kidding me?
I'm breathing, guys. I slept zero. How are you guys?
You gotta be on the verge of hypothermia. We're getting out of this wet, cold tents.
All I got, I have no option.
Like, there's no place to run this. Hypothermia is probably the one thing that could kill people out here quicker than anything. We're in the middle of nowhere, so there's no hiking out of this.
Uh-oh. It ripped.
That's all right, gotta get this thing. Let's get the fire going.
Fortunately, we've got some fuel from our camp stoves to help get the fire started.
Go. There it goes. This whole area is going to be toasty warm. I just hope this roof holds up.
Once you see smoke, soon comes fire, and right after that comes smiles. That dry heat is always a welcome and enjoyable sight.
I'm in a much better mood and attitude knowing that at least I'll start dry tonight. And maybe this rain will hold.
After all of that misery, all of that work, we wake up the next day in the sunny, sunny sun.
What a beautiful day.
Today's the day. All of our stuff's dried up. Now it's time to get the old mission done.
have a good feeling about this place.
This is our last day to go after those huge Arctic char.
We need to split up. We need to cover as much river as we can. Brian and I are heading downstream to the tributary of the closest lake. Chris and Jay, they're gonna hike back up to the headwaters near the base of the mountains. Hopefully both groups find some big fish today.
Take your pick, but choose wisely.
I'm gonna roll streamer with a little bit of an intermediate sink tip on that.
It's the money maker right there.
I'm after the coolest looking fish in this river. I don't need to catch a million char, but I do want to catch one that's the most awesome looking fish you've ever seen in your life.
That red one right there, that's the fish we want.
This fish has skipped orange and went straight to fire red. I've never seen anything like it. I'm staying here until this fish is caught.
Oh yeah.
Got him.
Oh! I hooked him once. He jumped out of the water. He threw the hook. When do you ever get a second shot at a fish eating again? Those are big Arctic char, and this river is loaded with them. The trick's gonna be sneaking up on them because these things are gonna spook the minute you walk down there. So you gotta like G.I. Joe crawl and hopefully get a cast out in front of them.
Oh my gosh, he's huge. Come on, just eat it this time, eat it.
He ate it.
The Arctic char is at the very top of my list of fish in the world. When I hook one of these fish, I've got the prettiest girl in the ballroom dancing with me.
Get in there, yeah! Woo!
To actually lift one of these fish, it's almost like you're mining this gem out of the water.
Look at that fish, look at the peach on that.
This fish looks like it was painted on a canvas, and you're just like, I can't believe what I am seeing right now.
Today's like one of the greatest days of my life. This is what I dream about.
An Arctic char in spawning colors. That is the only fish that I wanted to catch in Greenland was that fish, and I just kept trying.
This guy must be one cool cucumber. Because if there's anybody that can agitate someone, it's me.
Oh, he did!
Finally hooked this thing in the mouth.
I was just right on top of him, and then, bam, had him.
You're running.
I was running down the bank as fast as I could. I'm tripping, I'm falling on these holes, and I must have went down 150 yards.
Come on, baby, show me that fire belly.
There's a little tributary, and managed to get the fish over into some shallow water and land it.
Look at the colors on that.
This is why we came. We found it.
Have you ever seen anything like that?
Wow, look at those teeth.
Woo! Yeah! Last day, final countdown. The sun came out. We catch the biggest char I've ever caught in my entire life. That's it, done. I don't need any more. I'm ready to leave this country, this beautiful country.
I love this place, but I'm so ready to get out of Greenland. The mix of freezing cold temperatures, rain, snow, slush, and ice. This was an ass kicker.
Greenland is like nowhere else in the world but a place to behold. But this has got to be the toughest place to survive.
Check it out, reindeer. Look at them, oh my God. It's insane.
I have total respect for all the people that live here in Greenland. This environment is one of the harshest I've ever been in, and the people that live here, they are as tough as it gets.
It is an unforgiving place, but so worth it. And I'm gonna miss it. This is one place that I can definitely come back to.